Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take an early look at the new features in Messages for iOS 10. So perhaps one of the most interesting features of iOS 10 is going to be all the enhancements to the Messages app, because you can do all these different things besides just sending simple text messages now. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So here I've started a conversation with one of my demo accounts and I can type some text just like before. Now you notice that the send button is now this up arrow on the right, and I can just tap it and it will send the message as before. But I can do different things now by tapping and holding that arrow, and this gives me some options there. You can see I can animate the bubble using one of the things at the top. So I can animate, say, with a slam, and I can tap that and you can see how it appears. I could try loud, and that's how it would look. Gentle, and that's the animation there. Or invisible ink, which gives this little animation there, and then the person has to tap it in order to see what's there. So let's send that one. I'm going to tap that blue arrow there and it sends it, and we're seeing what they see. So you can see here they can't read what the text is until they tap on the bubble, and then it appears. So this is useful for creating a little suspense, or for perhaps if you think somebody's looking over their shoulder, then they can wait to tap that bubble until they have some privacy. Now if you do the same thing, tap and hold the blue up arrow there, and you see at the top it's got two options, bubble or screen. If I switch to screen, I will get a variety of these full screen animations. The first one's balloons. You notice those dots there, the five dots. So I could swipe right to left to go to the second dot and see confetti, lasers, fireworks, or the last dot is this shooting star animation. So, and I can send that one there, and then the person receiving it will get this full screen animation at the time they receive the message, and then the message itself will just be a normal message after that. Now text itself can use emoji in a different way now. Now before, of course, you could type emoji. So for instance, if instead of using pizza there, I could tap the emoji button at the bottom left and I could find the pizza icon. But notice now when I tap the emoji button, I've got two words that are colored, and these are things that perfectly match an emoji. So instead of actually having to find the pizza emoji, I can simply type the word pizza and then go to the emoji keyboard and tap the word pizza, and I will replace that word with the emoji. In cases where there are multiple matches, like for bike, I tap that and I get choices. So now I can send this message with emoji in it without ever really needing to use the emoji keyboard. Now when somebody receives a message, they can also respond to it very quickly without using the keyboard at all. All you need to do is tap and hold the bubble. So let me tap and hold that last message there, and I will get these little responses here, like a thumbs up, a thumbs down, a laugh, exclamation points, question mark, or a heart. And I can respond very easily by just tapping one of those. And it actually puts the response there next to the bubble, so it doesn't put it as a new message there. So it's a quick, easy way to respond. I know I'm always responding with OK or yes, I like that, or something like that. And this is a quick way to do it with really just one tap and a drag, or two taps. Now you can draw or handwrite in two different ways. One way is simply to use that drawing key at the bottom right corner. Do that and now you can draw or write something. And it's just a simple image, and I hit done and it sends it. And I could actually, I could add a comment here if I wanted to include with the image, and I could send that off. And this just appears as a normal image. This is great because it seems to be backwards compatible, because it's just sending an image. So if you send it to somebody with an older device or a non-Apple device, they'll still get this image. Now the even cooler way to do writing or drawing is to tap the arrow there to the left side of the message, and then use the heart with the two fingers button there. And these are animated messages here. And you've got two sets. Usually you start off here with the sketch, hold, tap on the right. And you can tap it, change to tap, drag, hold to do different things. So sketch is self-explanatory. I can sketch something and not only will the sketch appear, but you can see there, you can see how it drew itself. So it's going to draw itself just like you drew it. So it's an animated sketch. And I can continue now to, we can go back and forth just sketching things to each other. But you also have the ability to do things like the, you can see, hold with two fingers will give me a heart. And as I continue to hold, it will beat. And then it sends. A quick tap gives me this ring. If I tap on it and go to tap, drag, hold here, I can do a quick tap, two fingers, gives a little kiss. A two fingers with a drag gives like this broken heart. And then a hold with one finger gives this glowy animation right there. Now you can actually go ahead and bring video up with that video button there and then actually do these animations so you can sketch over live video and send this little video bit that's got you know, a heart or a drawing going on while the video is recording. You can also tap on the little color button there to change the colors as well. Now this actually can go way beyond this because if you notice, if I tap the little arrow button there and I get the photos and heart button and I also get this little apps button here, I go to apps and there's a few things there by default. One is I can share music, so it shows me some recently played things here, and I assume if I've got Apple Music and the person I'm sending to has Apple Music, I can share some music with them. But you can also either swipe over or tap the four dots on the bottom left and it brings up all these additional things you can do. So there's these images and there's this little database of weird animated GIFs. I'm not exactly sure where these come from, but there's a ton of them and you can search them. So if I wanted to send a funny cat, I can search for cat and I'll get a whole bunch of cat ones. And I assume those all change over time. In addition, I could, let's go to those four dots again. You see where it says Classic Mac, there's these things called stickers. And I could send a sticker there and I can add a comment to it. So it's just another way of doing an image. There's this store here. If I tap store and I could actually go in and it shows me which ones I've got enabled. I go to featured here and I can get new ones. So third party should be able to add new ones. So there's going to be tons of these little sticker packs with animated images that you can add from your favorite brands or you know, TV shows, movies, cartoons, whatever it is. There'll be probably some sticker packs that you can get and add to messages. Not sure what happens though when you send one and the person on the other end doesn't have that pack. My feeling is they're just sent as animated GIFs, so the person will get them no matter what they've got, and probably they'll even work on Android devices as well. If they're just animated GIFs, they should work fine.